Like many of my colleagues, I rise in opposition to SB 565. The senator who has introduced this legislation noted in his co-sponsorship memo that Pennsylvanians have a fundamental constitutional right to keep and bear arms. But what about the inherent rights of mankind that our state constitution guarantees, specifically the right to enjoy life and liberty? In Philadelphia, there have been almost 400 fatal shooting victims so far this year, and over 1,500 non-fatal shooting victims. Just today, I was fortunate to have greeted ninth graders from my community who came here to visit our Capitol. But I know that these young black boys have had a family member, a peer, a classmate, or a neighbor who has been struck by this violent epidemic that we're dealing in our city. And I fear that this legislation would only make them, my neighbors, and the people that I represent less safe. So, Mr. Speaker, I rise because I fear that this bill will make us less safe, but I also rise because of what appears to me to be a vicious attempt at flooding guns into our black and brown communities and then locking up everyone caught in the current. This same week, we are considering bills that impose mandatory minimums for offenses that include firearms. Yet this bill says that anyone in Philadelphia may openly carry a firearm, rifle, or shotgun. So on one hand, we wish to further lax the gun control that we have in our Commonwealth. Yet on the other hand, we wish to enact penalties on people who commit offenses with those guns. So, Mr. Speaker, I fear that this bill is going to fan the flames of an already raging gun violence epidemic in my city of Philadelphia. If the maker had it their way, our black and brown communities would be devastated, with countless people either left dead or in prison. It is a farce to believe that this would result in anything else. I'll be a strong no on this bill, and I ask my colleagues to join me. Thank you.